Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and we've got another movie up for review here. 2021, I did actually mention in the previous video that it's kind of rare for me to watch 2021 movies, but seem to be picking up, so I might have misspoken earlier. But Stowaway is a 2021 science fiction movie that came out on Netflix, and I think it's on Prime as well, but I watched it on Netflix, and it's got this feel of a movie that is partially grandeur and partially like it's got the effects of a sci-fi TV movie kind of thingy. So I don't know, it's like two worlds really colliding a little bit. It is a very big budget and all that stuff, but it does have its moments. The movie stars Anna Kendrick, who I absolutely adore, Daniel Day Kim, another actor who I really like, Shamir Anderson, who I've never seen before, and the awesome Toni Collette. Right, so at least three out of four is pretty good. I actually didn't like the character that Shamir Anderson plays, and basically it's this three-member crew of Toni Collette, Anna Kendrick and Daniel Day Kim, who are set off. They're on a 2-year mission to Mars, and there's they're getting connected to the space station. I think it is the ISS. I'm not really sure, or some kind of a space station in between. So they headed off onto Mars from their rocket. They go in and they get connected. They find out there's an accidental stowaway. A support engineer named Michael Adams, who's a very young, who's supposed to be pretty young. He didn't look really young in that in his role. The actor doesn't look that young, by the way, is what I'm trying to say. And unfortunately, he was injured and he was stuck in one of the in the vents. When they take him out, unfortunately, it also destroys a device that scrubs the carbon dioxide. So now they have to make do with some other devices. The emergency lithium hydroxide canisters. These are sciencey stuff. I am not very good with sciencey stuff. So they can only last for so long, and they do a calculation that says these canisters can only take care of two passengers, for the trip. So they need to find out something else. They try to use some of the algae that is supposed to be an experiment done by Daniel Day Kim's captain, because he's supposed to get to Mars and work on part of the algae. Unfortunately, he has to use that so that they can generate more oxygen, but majority of it gets destroyed. It doesn't work out, so they're kind of stuck. So the only other way they can do is they need to climb the tethers and recover some liquid oxygen from a launch vehicle that they have, and that way they'll be able to have enough oxygen for the four of them. The other two, Barnett and Michael, which is played by Toni Collette and Daniel Day Kim, they feel like they should probably think about sacrificing the Michael, the stowaway character, but they're not able to bring themselves to it. And finally, the only option is to carry those two oxygen cylinders. However, when they're trying to fill the two tanks, that will be able to sustain, the additional two characters more than two characters, two passengers rather. Unfortunately, an accident happens, and Zoe, played by Anna Kendrick, she's a medical doctor. She slips up and they lose one of the canisters. So she's got to go down under heavy radiation from a solar flare. And she decides to sacrifice her life so that she can get the canister down, so the other three can survive. And as the movie ends, she's resigned to her fate, sitting on top of it, just watching the universe pass her by as she's going. And the other three have said their kind of goodbyes to her. That's basically the entire movie. There's a little bit of bonding that happens, but it doesn't. It's not the kind of movie that you would see too much excitement happening. It's more of they've tried to do a lot of character development, show you what these four three astronauts as well as, or three scientists and the stowaway character is all about. I actually think it kind of misses out on the fact that I don't really, I like the three scientists, but I don't really like the stowaway character. He doesn't really have too much going for him, and yet it's possibly a choice of the actor. I have never heard of this guy before. Whereas the other three are pretty well-known actors, especially in this genre. Daniel Day Kim, of course, Anna Kendrick and Toni Collette. Three really awesome actors. So I guess that's what's missing, because you don't really feel sorry for Michael, the character Michael, at any point in time. Like, he's just kind of like there. But the movie's title is The Stowaway. So I don't really know how to feel about this movie. Like, while it did have its moments, I wasn't really feeling the kind of tension and loss that is supposed to be portrayed throughout parts of this film. I did like it though. It was not bad. I'll give it a 7 out of 10. And I think mainly because of Anna Kendrick. I mean, she and, you know, the others do pretty much well. But I think this is kind of like her film to shine, as she's, like, you know, sitting on the top of there. You do really feel a little bit of it, because she says, you know, she wants to go to Mars, and she's just sitting there watching, you know, looking on Mars among the stars, while resigned to her fate that she's going to die in the next few minutes. And that's pretty much where the movie ends, so you don't really get to see anything else. Like I said, I think it's kind of like a one-time watch. I don't really see myself ever trying to get into this film again. But I'm still giving it a 7 out of 10. So maybe someday down the line, I might want to watch it once. Hey, what's that movie with Anna Kendrick in space? So that's pretty much it, guys. 7 out of 10 for me. Thank you. Good night.